Hi, Bill. My name's Mike, and I get told a lot that I ask too many questions. So my question to you is, what do you think would be different if we, as a culture, were more encouraging of asking questions and being inquisitive and, you know, trying to learn, trying to understand things, especially with kids?
This is a great question. Can you ask too many questions? I mean, hypothetically, you cannot ask too many questions. You cannot investigate too thoroughly, could you possibly? However, what your friends may be responding to is something a little different. If somebody is trying to execute a task, let's say sew on a button, and you ask this person, why are you sewing on a button? Why are you using thread to sew on a button? Why are you using a needle and thread to sew on a button? The person would think that you're not paying attention. This is possible, that you're not thinking for yourself, that you're not using your own common sense. I'm not saying that's what's happening, but you reported at the top of your little segment here that people say you ask too many questions. I don't know. In other words, it could be a social interaction thing. If you were sewing on a button, in general, you're doing it because the button fell off or the button has never been put on the piece of clothing in the first place, and you're using a needle and thread because that is our current button attaching technology. There are other technology, little plastic strings, but they're not nearly as aesthetically pleasing as thread. So I mention this only by way of example. Along this line, if you I'm in New York right now, and it's the holiday season, and on a very famous department store, it says, believe in the holiday season. Wouldn't it be better, or how would it be different, if it said question?
Whoa.
That's a good question, man of questions. But be aware of your surroundings. Be aware of social interactions. Don't annoy people. Carry on.